I need your advice regarding HotPoint oven error codes.
HotPoint ovens aren't that hot, which is part of the problem.
That doesn't help me figure out what is wrong with it today.
F0 is the error code for a stuck touchpad. It means the touchpad itself is shorted out or damaged, or the control board is defective, assuming you haven't held down the button too long.
If I held down the button too long to try to get it to do something, I'd know I had some sort of error.
F1 is the error for a stuck touchpad as well, but like F0, you can try to clear it with a cancel button push.
And if that doesn't work, reboot to see if it is really the control board.
If you get F2 on a HotPoint oven, that means it has detected overheating during baking.
I'd have an inkling if that was correct if the food was burning, but it wasn't.
The relays on the baking or broiler elements may be shorted.
That's definitely something to fix. Getting too hot can also kill the control board.
If you're getting the F2 error during the self-cleaning cycle, the temperature is over 900 degrees. If it gets hotter than that, the thermal fuse or electrical fuse may blow, so the system won't come back on until the fuses are fixed.
Better a blown fuse than a burned down house. But I don't use the self-cleaning cycle because it so often burns out control boards or even melts oven liners.
If the mechanical components are fine, then the issue is the temperature sensor or sensor wiring.
A sensor wiring short could cause the oven to overheat while it is shorting out, too.
F3 is the error for an open or shorted temperature sensor circuit.
That's almost always the wiring or the sensor.
F4 is the same thing too, when you want to know how to fix it. F5 though, is either the control panel or control board, though the issue might be the clock.
I've heard of fixing clock errors by switching from military time to 12-hour clock mode.
That solution usually works on Decor ovens, but you could try it on a HotPoint oven.
And if I can't change the clock time or get other errors while I try it, I know it is probably the control board.
The F9 error is for a lock switch fault. If it isn't the wiring to the door switch, check to see if the lock switch is broken.
That's obvious when I try to open the door to check the switch and can't.
You can try putting the oven in self-cleaning mode before canceling it to cause the lock to engage and disengage. If that fails to get it to release, the issue is the lock relays or motor.
Or a really jammed door.
More likely a damaged hinge and door lock at once.
But if I can't get to it because the thing is locked shut, I know to call for service.
Did if the relays are shorted and welded shut or melted to the inside of the oven.
For any electrical issue that bad, the only part shocking to me should be the cost to repair it, which is why I'd call for service.
On a HotPoint oven, the H indicator means that the surface is too hot to touch. That's not an error message.
If the oven and stove failed to get hot so often its normal operational messages were mistaken for errors, keeping the oven that long was a mistake.
If the oven isn't heating, the first thing to check is the igniter. It may be shorted out or it may not generate enough of a current to ignite the gas.
I know you can get it to glow but not ignite when it is dying, and it would be obvious if it wasn't igniting.
Yeah, you'd see gas valve open but no flame errors.
The gas smell would also be a warning. However, I don't have a gas oven.
If you don't have power, the oven won't run.
That would be obvious by the dark display as well as the dark oven.
You can verify it is a power loss by opening the oven and seeing if the light comes on, whereas a burned out control board will be dark but the rest of the unit may light up.
A blown power fuse and thermal fuse can do the same thing.
If the oven isn't heating evenly, first make sure the shelves in it are even.
I put that in the category of common sense.
Then see if the heating elements are both working.
Most HotPoint ovens have one on top and one on bottom. You just turn it on and see if both come on and stay on.
And if one of them doesn't, you know you have to replace the heating element.
And that's assuming it didn't burn out with the last cleaning cycle.
If you clean your oven with chemicals not meant for an oven, you could get chemical residue on the elements that affects their efficiency.
Baked on grease and char would be worse.
So clean the elements but not with spray cleaners that can affect their performance or short them out.
That makes cleaning the oven that much more work.
You could check to see if that's the problem by checking the resistance of the heating elements with a multimeter. Infinite and zero resistance are both bad.
I know that if the oven won't turn on at all, to check the power to it, though it isn't like we unplug it.
There's always the chance running the microwave with poor shielding caused electrical problems for the oven.
It is more common for the heat from the oven and especially leakage from the exhaust to mess up the microwave.
If the food is burning when you use the oven, check your settings.
This isn't a case of selecting bake when I meant broil or vice versa. And if it was, that's not a reason to call for service but mom to teach me to cook again.